Ebola virus was discovered in 1976 after two deadly outbreaks struck Zaire and Sudan in Central Africa. Since then, Ebola viruses have emerged periodically in this region, causing hemorrhagic fever and killing up to 90% of the people they infect. There is no vaccine or treatment for Ebola infection. Scientists are trying to understand how Ebola and related emerging viruses survive in nature, spread to people and animals, and why they infect some species but not others. With this knowledge, researchers hope to learn how to prevent these viruses from causing infection and death in humans. Researchers from the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases have joined colleagues in the Republic of Congo to study Ebola in its natural setting. Through a research collaboration formed in 2012, they have established field camps in the jungle and a laboratory in the capital city of Brazzaville. Following a 10-hour drive, the team arrives at the village of Libonga. With partners from the Wildlife Conservation Society, the Public Health Agency of Canada, and the Congo National Institute for Public Health, the team hikes several hours into the bush to establish their camp.
Alan, which way are we going?
Led by guides, they follow narrow hunting trails that frequently pass over, through, and around creeks and marshes. Their camp sits near the habitats of rodents and other animals that can harbor Ebola and other viruses. The researchers want to study how environmental factors such as animal migration, food sources, and weather might affect disease outbreaks. The team spends a long day setting nearly 100 rodent traps throughout the jungle. During their expedition, they also look for bats and discover a colony high in a tree. The researchers return that evening to place nets in hope of catching a few specimens. The research team live traps several species of bats and begins collecting samples for their studies. When handling animals, scientists wear protective gowns so they do not come in contact with any of the infectious fluids. An air filtration device on their belt blows filtered air into the face shield to prevent unwanted exposure to any airborne contaminants.
Okay.
The team members measure the live animals and collect swabs to test for pathogens.
Look at this, it's 65, which is the largest I've ever seen in this species.
They also draw blood and place the serum into labeled vials. Then they release the animals back into the wild. The samples will be analyzed either locally or in the United States to determine whether they show signs of infection with Ebola or other viruses of interest. When the work is done, the scientists disinfect their research areas. Once back at camp, the team settles in for a meal. After about 2 weeks, they hike back to the village where they secure their specimens, return to their laboratory, and begin planning the next phase of their research.